Hi, I'm Dan Camarda. Welcome to True Blue Market View. In this video, we're going to be talking about how to create a subscription link for your YouTube channel, as well as how to overlay a subscribe button in your videos that is interactive, that can be clicked on to have a YouTube user subscribe to your channel and includes this flyout with your username and the number of subscribers that your channel has. First, in order to get the URL for your subscribe link to your YouTube channel, such as what you see here, which will subscribe to the True Blue Market View channel in the subscribe link in the video description, then this is actually very easy. All it is this URL shown on screen. Where True Blue Market View is highlighted on the end, you would simply change that to whatever your channel name is. Although it does say @_user, and your username might be the same as your channel name, you want to be sure that you include your channel name here, not your username. For example, on True Blue Market View channel, you see here my username is displayed as Dan Camarda. However, the channel itself is actually named True Blue Market View. And again, here in the URL, youtube.com/user/True Blue Market View, it may make you believe that the user is in fact True Blue Market View. Regardless of whatever your username might be, the way to know for sure what your channel name is if you can go to youtube.com/ and then whatever your channel name is and then press enter. If that takes you to your channel, then you know that you have the right channel name. As you can see, when I go to youtube.com/True Blue Market View, it redirects me to youtube.com/user/True Blue Market View. And this is the True Blue Market View channel. So let's talk about how to add a graphic to overlay in your videos, which serves as an interactive subscribe button. Shown here, the graphic that I like to use is in fact a graphic of a button that looks like the YouTube icon, and it also reads subscribe. While logged into your YouTube or Google account where your YouTube channel resides, you want to go to your Creator Studio and under Channel, select Branding. It is the branding watermark that you want to use. Because I already have a branding watermark, I'm going to go ahead and remove it so that I can show you how to add yours. Click on Add a Watermark under Branding Watermark. Choose File. Navigate to the file that is your graphic that you're going to use for your overlay. Select it and choose Open. Click Save. And save once again. Now set what option you want as far as when to display this graphic overlay for your branding watermark. I typically choose to display it throughout the entire video. Then click Update. Let's go ahead and refresh this video and see if there is a change in the subscribe button. As you can see, the subscribe button has changed. This particular graphic is a little bit larger than the one previously used, and that is how you add an interactive subscribe button on all of your videos. The reason that I like to use something that reads subscribe is it serves as more of a call to action. You could use your channel icon, you could use your picture, company logo, or any number of things. To find graphics or graphic ideas, you could simply go to Google and search images. You could download a graphic from YouTube directly from this address here. Or you could download a free open source vector graphic program similar to Adobe Illustrator by the name of Inkscape, available at inkscape.org, and create your own graphic. You could also get a program that is similar to Adobe Photoshop, which is also a free open source program by the name of Gimp, available at gimp.org. This could also be used during the creation of a graphic or company logo, although more commonly you would use a vector graphic program as it is much more effective for resizing a vector graphic image than it is a bitmap image, which is what Adobe Photoshop and Gimp works with, is bitmap images, whereas Adobe Illustrator and Inkscape are vector graphic programs. And vector graphic programs are used more for creating graphics, more so than a bitmap editor. That concludes this segment. Thanks for watching. We'll catch up with you guys again next time.